Hello, everybody. Welcome to my 8:30 yin practice. You have me for the next hour. So I just want you to take some time here to get comfortable in your space that you're at. This is all about being comfortable and relaxed and taking that time for you here. For all of you that don't know me, I've been a hot shop instructor for 3 years now. I've been teaching yoga for two. Most of us know me from the Northwest location and the Southwest location, but sending a little love to everybody there. So it's going to be about the heart chakra today, about opening your heart and allowing yourself to relax through your open body and allowing your breath to take control through your body. So I just want you to lay down onto your mat here, get comfortable. I want you to check your body here, begin to wiggle your fingers, your toes. Just take a second here to check into yourself, rolling your shoulder blades down and into your mat, allowing yourself to just simply let go here and beginning to draw yourself inward towards yourself. With yin today, it's all about your breath, your prana. So when you're ready, I want you to begin to engage with your breath. We're going to take three breaths together. With your first inhale, fill from your belly, fill all the way up, fill up. And audible sigh, let it go. In from your chest, fill up. And audible sigh, let it go. Finally, both chest and belly, biggest breath of your evening, fill all the way up. And let it out. I want you to set an intention here. What's something that can help guide you along through your practice today? As we draw into this practice, I want you to bring your feet together to touch. Allow your knees to sway open, bend through both of your knees. Supta Baddha Konasana, recline the butterfly. Allow yourself to relax right there. You can open up through your chest, cactus your arms nice and wide open. If you want, you have blocks or pillows, place a block and a pillow underneath each one of your legs here, allowing yourself to open up to the space. I'm gonna read us a little synopsis today for the heart chakra. So a little guided meditation to start our practice today. It's called, You're Free to Open Your Heart. Open your heart to the people you love. Open your heart to the world. Open your heart to God, to the universe, to life, and all the creatures and creations in it. Open your heart as much as you can. It's safe to open your heart now. There was a time when you believed that the only way to protect yourself was to shut down and close your heart. You have learned so much. You have learned the powers of honesty, compassion, forgiveness, and kindness. You will no longer become stuck or trapped if you open your heart. You can leave it if you want to. You can say what you need to. You no longer need to protect yourself by guarding your heart with the heavy armor you wore in the past. Now you are free. Free to open your heart. Free to open yourself to the universe. Take a big inhale, fill up. And let it go. A woman I met in Sedona gave me a lovely visualization to use to picture your heart. In front of your heart, see a beautiful rosebud tightly closed. Whenever you want to open your heart, picture the rose blooming wide, beautiful, alive, and fragrant. Whenever you want to retreat, turn the rose back into that bud. Open your heart to the world, to the people who live in it. Open yourself to creation. Open your heart to yourself, to God, to life. Life will become magical. And you'll think back and smile. You will wonder why it took you so long to open your heart. Open your heart as much as you can, as much as you choose. Share it with the world. From the heart, inhale, fill up. And slowly let it go. To take your time here. You can place your arms or hands to the outside of both of your knees. Slowly draw your knees back in the center, bringing them all the way together. As you get there, I want you to begin to heel toe your feet to the outside edges of your mat. Allow your knees to fall inward. Recline pyramid. Now as you draw into this space, you may find yourself to be able to go a little bit farther than mat width distance. to go as far as you can. Allow those knees to come inward. If you need to and your knees are not touching, you can always take a pillow or a block, place it in between both of your knees. Just once again, check in here. Roll through your shoulder blades. Ground yourself into your mat, into your space. And stay connected with your breath. We have three tapas in yin. Finding your edge. Finding stillness. And then holding that stillness for a set period of time. So as you allow yourself to wind down, to draw yourself back into your physical body, both mind, heart. So that intention you have for yourself here. With everything that's going on in the world outside us, this is a good time just for you to connect to yourself. To stop thinking about everything that's happening and focus on you. This is that chance, that opportunity for you to just be yourself. Staying connected with your breath. Allow your senses to take over. Simply closing your eyes allows your other senses to rise, like sound, touch. Allowing yourself to focus more on even the beating of your heart. Feeling your chest rise and fall. That sensation of inhaling through your nostrils and out past your lips. Feeling grounded, feeling connected to who you are. Remembering to trust yourself in your space today. Always remember, there's always different ways your body reacts to different postures we're in, and always remembering to take any modifications that you need to. You take a couple more breaths right here, allowing yourself to really fill up through your chest cavity. Allow that air to flow through your body, that energy. Take one final breath right here, inhale. Exhale, slowly let it out, dissipate from your lungs. You can remove that block, slowly begin to heel toe your feet back into center. Once your feet touch, just windshield wiper here now from side to side, but take it really slow, reminding yourself that you're staying connected with your breath. As you inhale, you travel from side to side. As you exhale, you find your right or left side. Always remembering to take that time to slow down here. We're in no hurry, we're in no rush. One final time to either side. Allowing yourself to draw back into center. When you're ready, inhale, pull both of your knees into your chest, wrap your arms around your shins, give yourself a nice big hug here. Roll those shoulder blades down into your mat. Find that lower back, drop down to your mat. When you're ready, flexion and compression of your spine, pull your forehead up into your knees, squeeze through on your inhale. And when you're ready to exhale, draw your head back down. I want you to continue doing this two or three more times with your own breath. Remembering to take it slow, stay connected. You're at one with yourself right here. Your last one, I want you to extend your legs, reach your hands above your head, take that good evening stretch. Roll through your wrists and ankles one way. Oh, switch directions, moving the opposite way. It's amazing how much something so simple your body loves and craves it misses. And exhale, plying yourself through. I want you to land yourself. Just cactus your arms open here for a second. Feel that whole connection from your feet all the way up through your spine and hips and legs and arms, your neck, third eye at the top of your head. Send some love to yourself right here. Big inhale. Letting that love out, release it. Slowly take your time. You're gonna bring yourself into fallen tree on your right hand side. Take your bend through your right leg. Place your right foot to the inner left thigh. Allowing it for external rotation here. And remembering to try to keep an open heart here, an open chest for our practice today. Wherever you need to go, when you close your eyes here, what do you see? You see colors. What runs through your mind? What goes through your head? The color of your heart chakra is green. So you'll notice I like to use essential oils when I run my yin practice. Green, so peppermint today, to really allow yourself to really connect with your heart. Big inhale, allow yourself to land. Soften through your body. Just be at ease with where you are. Allow yourself to feel at ease about who you are. And always remembering that you're not alone. And every day, whatever happens, we're always in this together. Eventually you get a tingling sensation through your fingers. It's not a good thing. Make sure you prop yourself up. Use some blocks for underneath your arms or underneath your elbows. Once again, a block can go underneath your right leg here. And again, practice. We usually stand in our poses from anywhere between 2 to 5 minutes. I want you to draw yourself back in here. Connect with your breath. Check into your mind. What's something you're proud of today? It's so easy to focus on the negative. But it's even sometimes a struggle to think of those things. Take a couple more breaths right here. One last inhale, fill up. Exhale, let it go. Slowly take your time. You can use your right hand again. Guide your right knee back in a center. Left hand's gonna come up. Grab the outside of your right knee. Trick it all the way across. Supine twist. All the way over to your left hand side. Drawing your right shoulder blade down. Making sure you can take your gaze over top of your right shoulder here. But make sure you take your time to land. It's about that the time you take to land in the pose. Yin can be quite difficult for a lot of us because it requires you to stay as much as you can still. So always remembering your edge may change through this practice and through as you begin to warm up our body and our spine. So always remember you can use blocks, pillows, set yourself up, be comfortable here. It's all about getting into that myofascial tissue. That web-like substance between our muscles and our bones. Gives us a chance to release. Allow that fiber to kind of relax and let go. Always remembering to stay connected to your breath here. Always remembering at any point today through our practice to, if you need water, grab water. If you want to use essential oils or use a mist, go for it. Do whatever you have to do to make you feel relaxed and comfortable. Just simply breathe. the time we spend so much of our time worrying about how we're supposed to act or how we're supposed to be or how we're even supposed to feel. Always remember, you have the right to feel however you need to. Always remembering not to hold it in, to let it come out. Just like that passage I wrote at the beginning about your armor that you create around your heart. This is that time to let it go. If not for anybody else, for yourself. I want you to take your left hand. I want you to place your left hand on your heart. I want you to just take a second here and feel your heartbeat. Feeling thankful for yourself. Take a couple more breaths here. Connection. Literally, what yoga means is to connect. Draw your gaze slowly back into center. Inhale. Exhale, let it go. Ha. Slowly take your next turn. Inhale, pull your right knee all the way across your body. Keep it into your chest. Interlock your fingers below your right knee for wind relieving pose here on our right hand side. Just take a second here. Really concentrate on keeping your left hip down. You're not pulling too far on the right to pull it through. Take a big inhale. Exhale, pull, squeeze into your side body. Away. Doing that with a couple breaths here. As you inhale, you draw towards yourself. As you exhale, wave. One more time. Extend your right leg all the way down your mat. Take a second here. Readjust your hips. Take your left foot, place it, bend it through your left leg. Place your left foot in the inner right thigh. You're coming into that fallen tree now on our left hand side. I want you to take a second here and scan your body. I want you to understand now the differences you're feeling on our left hand side compared to where you were on your right hand side. So take that big inhale, find that space, land, let it go. I always like to allow myself to find those poses as I breathe, as I let that exhale go, just to relax, to let go of any of that tension you're holding inside your body. And once again, you may notice one side of your body may be a little bit different than your other side, and that's totally normal. Just understanding that, understanding where your body is feeling it. For some of us that are home now for 24 hours a day, it can be quite hard to escape your mind now and escape the place you're in. It's not escaping, it's being able to be you. So now that we have that time, we always did, to take that time to send love to yourself. Whether it's first thing you do in the morning, or the last thing you do before you go to bed. Big inhale, fill up from your belly, and let it out. Remembering that you're in no rush, you're in no hurry. Let's take that valuable time that we have to love yourself more. because there's never such a thing as too much love for yourself. Take about 3 more breaths right here. Feeling the sensation of your chest rising and falling as your belly rises and falls. One final inhale for love. Audible sigh, let it go. Slowly take your time. You can use your left hand, draw your left knee back in the center. You can take your right hand to the outside, pull your left knee over into your right hand side. Coming into your second supine twist now. Always remember there's modifications here. Can come all the way down like so. You don't have to. You can bend through your bottom right leg, bend through both of your legs to come over. You may even bend through both knees and allow your knees to stack on. If there's space, you can take a pillow or a block. Always remembering whatever is easiest for you to get here, as long as you can find that stillness. Making sure that your left shoulder blade stays connected to your mat. So if it isn't, draw it back. You've gone too far. And it's easier to keep your left shoulder down. Keep your left arm all the way out, expand, and then take your gaze over top of your left shoulder. And you'll notice when you take your gaze over top of your shoulder, it also helps keep that left shoulder blade down. Now take a second here. Where are you feeling the sensations? Where are things happening in your body? For some of us, we may be quite flexible that we don't feel anything. And for some of us, we might feel it in our glute area, our leg, our hip, especially the hip flexor. Maybe some of us even in our lower back. We are okay. We are proud. We are loved. We are cherished. And we are important. I've got this. I've got this. Little subtle messages you can send to yourself. Reminding who you are and understanding that our purpose is what we create. Just like the stories of our lives, the pages, or like the days, each day a new story, a new life, a new chapter for you to begin to write. The author of your own book, of your story. And your story grows every day. Each event, each moment, growing you into the person you are becoming. Ever-changing, but through it all, always remembering to love yourself. Allow that lock to be broken around your heart. Give that key to somebody. Always making sure that you have that key to unlock your own heart. You always have it. Let's take a couple more breaths right here. Allow your chest to rise and fall. Stay connected. One final inhale, bring your gaze back to center. Exhale, let it out. Slowly pull your left knee back across your body, all the way through back into center. When we're leaving pose now on our left hand side, interlock your fingers below your left knee. Take a second here, roll through your shoulder blades, draw your right hip back down, making sure you have equal weight distribution amongst both hips. When you're ready, inhale away, exhale, squeeze towards. Inhale up. Exhale, squeeze. One more time. You to draw your right knee back into your chest. Both knees come back in. Flexion compression one more time. Inhale, pull up. Both knees into your chest. Exhale. Come all the way down. Now, we're going to allow yourself to landmark yourself here. Bring your heels as close to the booty as you can. You're going to landmark the back of your heels with your middle finger, or as close as your fingers can get. Plant those palms down beside your hips when you're ready. Back bend here. Inhale, lift up your hips high up to the sky. Lift them up. Now, no tension on your neck here. This is all through your shoulders. What you're going to do is interlock your fingers underneath your sitting bones. Plant them down and then roll your shoulder blades one at a time for extra support here. To really open through your spine, through your chest, through your heart. I want you to focus on your breath here. Breathing in through your nose and out past your lips. You'll notice a little bit of travel as you breathe here. I want you to lift your hips slightly as you inhale and then back to a neutral center as you exhale. Taking your time with your breath, I want you to take three more of these. Nice and slow. And with your last inhale, lift as high as you can. Lift up, inhale, and hold for 4, 3, 2, 1, exhale, slowly uninterlock your fingers, allow your hips to settle back down into your mat, unroll your shoulder blades, and windshield wiper from side to side. Once again, inhaling as you travel, and as you exhale, either your left or right hand side. I want you to draw yourself back in the center. Allow yourself to align your hips, your feet, your shoulders in a nice line. Inhale, right leg high up to the sky. And then exhale, figure four over top of your left leg. When you're ready, inhale, pull your left knee into your chest. Reach the back of your left leg to the front of your left shin if you can. Maybe just the back of your left thigh if that is too much. Just allow your legs to do the work here. You can always take a pillow or a block and hold here as well, depending on how tight you are in your hips. Judges, remember you're never allowing that separation of your lower back to come off, and your shoulder blades are rolled into your mat. So if you feel any of that not connecting, just let go and allow your body to relax here. It's so, so important here in our yin practice is to be able just to relax. Because it's so hard even to take that time out of our day to relax, even if we're at home, or for all of us that are having our busy lives still and have to make this time for ourselves. This is about you time. This is your time to just relax and let go. To not think about every little thing we have to think about on a daily basis. And just be yourself. Now stay connected with your breath. Big inhale, fill up. Exhale, let it go. Lift your left leg high up to the sky. Lift it all the way up. Lift up. I want you to begin to roll through your left ankle one way. Big circles, nice and slow. Allowing those snap, crackle, pops to happen if they're there. Switch directions. Moving your opposite way. One final inhale, fill up. Exhale, plant your left foot all the way down. We're coming into another supine twist. So palms down beside your hips. Lift up your hips slightly over to your right-hand side of your mat and then plant your right foot over to your left-hand side, falling into your twists. This is one that we usually have a lot of people fall asleep. This is a nice relaxing spot here. So when you're ready, this is where I would like to, if you have a blanket, get comfortable, use those pillows. Just allow yourself to let go. Big inhale, finding that space. And when you're ready to land, take your gaze over top of your shoulder. And just let go. yourself to get comfortably here. Maybe your left hand on your heart, your right hand on your belly, maybe your palms down, palms up, cactus. There's no right or wrong here in this space. Just want you to pay attention to how your hands are though. Are your palms up? Allowing energy in. Allow that energy transfer to happen. Or your palms down. Grounding. Allowing your own energy to stay inward. And not so necessarily taking as much energy in. Wherever you are, allowing that lock, that armor, whatever you have around your heart to fall off. Allow yourself to be vulnerable in this moment. And in moments in life, we get scared in vulnerability. That's how we grow. That's how we learn about ourselves. Page of her book. Each chapter in her life. You've got this. Nice big inhale, fill up. And just let everything out. Love. Process where you are in your thoughts. Slow them down. If they're not about yourself or for yourself, allow them to go away, allow them to pass by. Time. Five. More breath right here. Nice full breath here with your last three. Allow your chest cavity to rise and fall. Really allow the expansion of your lungs as they rise and fall through your chest. One final inhale, fill up. Gaze back to center. Exhale, palms down beside your hips. When you're ready, slowly draw both of your legs back into center. Swing your hips back through into center. Right leg high back up to the sky. Exhale, plant it beside your left. Heel toe your feet just to the outside edge of your mat and wide-legged windshield wipers here. Really take your time on the traveling and the movement here. Allowing for that full range of motion through your hip flexors here. A little bit more openness through our back. You're really starting to feel your lower body start to really warm up through your space here. Engaging yourself. One more time each side. All the way back in the center. Heel toe your feet back underneath your hips. Find that nice long shoulders, hips, and feet line up. Left leg high up to the sky. Exhale, figure four, cross it over top of your right when you're ready. Inhale, pull your right knee into your chest. Reach the back of your right thigh, the front of your right shin. Once again, if your shoulder blades are lifting, you'll notice with myself even here, my left side is way tighter than my right hand side. So once again, I have to improvise or I have to use support, and that's okay. So always just remembering that. This is where the benefit of scanning your body and understanding what side of your body is a little bit different than the other. So once again, I can't even grab my leg here on this side, so I'm quite tight on our left-hand side. And depending on what side dominant you are on, and that's not necessarily the hand you write with. If someone was to... Don't do this too hardly. Someone wants to do, just give you a light push at home. Which foot leads forward first? It's your dominant side, so it takes a lot more of the brunt force. So allow yourself to just remember to breathe here. Sometimes, in most cases, the things we need the most, we avoid the most. So really connect with yourself here. Use your breath. Push all that energy, that prana, towards your hips. Really work through any tension, any tightness. Bring that oxygen, allow it to flow through your body. Bring that beautiful circle, that energy circle through yourself. One final inhale. Exhale. Lift that right leg high up to the eye, right foot high up to the sky. So again, rolling those shoulder blades in, land. Take your time, begin to roll through your ankle one way on this side. Switching directions, moving the opposite way. Big inhale, fill up. Exhale, slowly plant your right foot back down to your mat. Palms down beside your hips. Inhale, lift up your hips slightly. Over to your left-hand side, plant your hips back down and fall over to your right-hand side. Supine twist through our other side body. And once again here, find yourself landed, get comfortable, pillows, blanket, whatever you need to do here. When you're ready, lock it in. Big inhale, gaze falls over top of your shoulder. Exhale, land in your space. Let it all go. Let it fade away. Just land. Allow yourself to feel that connection with yourself. Checking into the little things that you notice in your body. Connection of your breath. Of your heart. Of your mind. And of course your spirit. That light that we have inside ourselves. Bad day, a cloudy day, or something or someone tries to dim that light inside us. Always know it never goes out. You know how dim it shines. You're always shining. Big inhale. Let it out. Intentions. The sound of nature. The sound of rain. All those little things that we have. And in most cases, sounds or senses, they take us places. They take us back through our memory. It is our biggest connection to our past, to our senses. Traumatic experiences we hold on to. The most happy experiences we hold on to. But we forget about all of those little experiences in between where you are. So stop each day and take that moment for yourself. Be grateful. Three final breaths right here.
proud, cherished, and loved. Take those big breaths here, flow that energy, inhale, fill up. Let it go. Ha. Next breath. Inhale, back your gaze in the center. Exhale, slowly take your time. Plant your palms down. Lift both of your legs back through inner center. Swing your hips back underneath your shoulders. Left leg high back up to the sky. This time, feet touch together. Plant your left beside your right and windshield wiper with feet together this time. Once again. We have that tendency to slow up, speed up, so take that time, slow down here. The next time your legs fall over to your right hand side, I want them to fall all the way through into your fetal position. Roll onto your right hand side, you can use your right tricep as a pillow. Just take a second here. What is something you feel right here? Security, safety. All of us, all of the beautiful things in this world, they start out small and they grow just like us. Like a bird out of its egg's nest, out of its nest, out of its egg. Like a caterpillar becoming a butterfly. We've got this, we're in this together. Time. You're eventually going to roll all the way over onto your belly. Take as long as you need. Take as much time as you need to. Allow yourself to relax here. Get acquainted with now our different sensations for our body here as we allow our front side body to check into your mat, into your space. I am going to be like this for most of it because I don't want to talk up to the floor. So allow yourself to relax here. And I want you to lift both of your feet up first. Just lift them up. And windshield wiper from side to side. I'm starting with a little motion here. Now in any of these poses that were down here, if you have a ball at home, a ball is quite lovely as well. In any of your points where you feel it, especially underneath your legs and stuff. Big inhale, fill up. And exhale, plant both of your feet back down. This is one of my favorite shoulder stretches. So when you're ready, cactus your arms here, plant them down. You're going to expand your right arm all the way over to your right hand side. This is a really good shoulder stretch. So when you're ready, push up position with your left hand. Inhale, push off your left. Begin to roll over to your right hand side. You're going to kickstand your left leg in behind your right. This is all of that pressure onto your right shoulder here. So if you need to see that again, all I did was plant down and kickstand all the way through. You may not be able to touch the ground behind you. That's okay. You have a couple of options here. You can even go back for the bind if you have the space. Wherever you are, make sure that you're creating no tension once again on your neck. This is all through your shoulder. Breathe through this here. Breathe, super important. And for three more breaths, we've got this. So inhale, fill up. Let it go. Inhale. And let it go. One final time, inhale, fill up. Exhale, slowly draw yourself all the way back through down into center. Ha. Good work. Draw your arms back into your cactus. We're switching sides right away. Expand your left arm this time out. Make sure you have enough space here. Right hand into push-up position. Push off your right, roll over top of your right hand side all the way through to your right side. Once again, maybe your foot touches. Maybe it doesn't, maybe it stays lifted. Wherever you are, you have the option to take the bind here as well. Always remembering that you can hold that posture as well. No tension through your neck. Find your breath. Once again, you can even notice on what side of your body it was a little bit different. Was it easier to get here or was it harder? We hold for three more breaths. Inhale, fill up. Let it go. Inhale. Let it go. One last time. Inhale. Exhale. Slowly roll yourself all the way back down and through. Take a second. Cactus through. Bend through both of your knees again. Lift your feet up back to the sky. And windshield wiper from side to side. Inhale, fill up. Exhale, let both feet down.
All right, so yogis, there's some of us that are gonna be able to get into this asana full. I am going to show you both variations. It's frog, you can do a half frog on either side, or you can do full frog. I am going to set the people that wanna come in half frog for now, set up. All you have to do is cactus your right feet comes up to your right-hand side. You can put your cheek down to your mat. If you are coming into full frog, it's a little bit different. I want you to create as much comfortableness for the knees as you can. You can roll up your mat, you can do whatever here. Super, super important if you're coming into full frog pose. But once you get in there, you're gonna be in there for quite some time. So, because if you're coming into your full frog, we're gonna do both sides. So super, super important. When you're coming into your frog, your feet are flat. So you draw knees nice and wide, feet are flat, and then you draw yourself in. So once you're in here, super, super important to find that spot. It's just like you would see a little frog about to pounce. Most importantly, you're in frog. You want to get yourself comfortable. So if you have a block for your head, get a block for your head. So you want to eventually allow yourself to draw yourself all as much down to your mat, to the ground as possible without allowing your hips to fall down to your mat. Try to keep your hips lifted. Trying to keep them at center as much as possible. This way. So once again, always remembering to support yourself with your knees because we're here for a while. If you're in your half frog, just relax, get comfortable. And it's gonna be quite hard for a lot of us to be able to stay in this posture. So breathe, use your breath. Allow yourself to get out of your headspace, to get out of your mind, to breathe through any comfort that you're feeling, always remembering that you can always come back into your half frog if you're not feeling this. We'll be doing it for a total of 6 minutes in your full frog. A lot of us love this posture, a lot of us don't, but people that usually don't like it as much are the people that need it the most. So allow yourself to breathe through this. You've got this. Feel rooted, stay strong. Feel rooted, feel in control. Big inhale. Exhale, let it go. Inhale. Exhale, let it go. Allow those thoughts to way. Stay that connection with yourself. Stay connected to who you are. Remember, allow those senses to take over. Allow them to check in. Remembering, you've got this. If you need to think of a word or a phrase to get yourself through this asana or through this pose, do it. Do whatever you need to do to allow yourself to find that depth, to let go, to really get into this asana as much as you can. If you are in your half frog on your right hand side, let's take three more breaths right there. Big inhale. Let it go. Inhale. Last inhale, fill up. Exhale, slowly draw your right leg back in. If you're only in your half frog, if you're in your frog, stay where you are. We're gonna switch to the other side with our half frogs on the other side. So when you're ready, left knee comes up. Inhale, pull your left knee up to your left hand side. Cactus your left leg, just like you did on your right hand side here. You can bring your right cheek down to your mat or your left, whatever you need to do to get comfortable here. Once again, for all of my froggers, froggies that are in their full frog, Just work through it. You've got this. Breathe through it. We've got 3 more minutes. We're almost there. Yes, I can. I've got this. I've got this. I find it easier too. If you need to, you can stack your fists with your hands and then stack your fists on top of each other and then allow your head to rest on that. So just one, it's up to you here. Whatever you need to do to guide yourself into that spot where you're able to work through it, to breathe through it. Yes, I can. I've got this. Only is our heart going to feel open when we leave the space today, but so are our hips, especially. We really worked on our lower back and our hips in our practice today, as well as getting that heart opening happening with our shoulders, allowing the locks to fall off our hearts. Maybe you even discovered something new about yourself today. We're always learning and we're always discovering. We're almost there, crew. One more minute right here. You've got this. Breathe. Nice full breath. All of that prana, that breath, to your hip flexors, through to your legs. Allow that, once again, that circle of energy to transfer through you, that oxygen to flow through your body, to bring all of that necessary blood through to all of your muscles and to all of our body parts. We need this for 5 more breaths right here. Let's go. Inhale. Exhale. Continue for 4 more times. Got this. 2 more breaths. Easiest way to get out of frog, walk yourself forward. Oh, my mic. Straighten out your legs, bend through both of your knees, windshield wiper from side to side. Everybody else in their half frog, take your time. Left leg comes all the way back down into center. Windshield wiper from side to side. Big inhale, exhale, plant down, take your time. I want you to plant your hands down. You're gonna push back, come onto your forearms first. We're gonna do a little back bend here. So allow yourself to come onto your forearms. We're gonna come into Sphinx pose right here. Allow yourself that nice plant hands, fingers spread wide, nice and wide, right in front. Allow that front gaze to lift up, allow your throat to open up, that throat chakra to open through. Towards your back. So you're going to use your chest cavity here. So inhale from your chest. Let it out. Focus all of that energy, all of that attention towards your lower back. 2 more breaths. Last inhale. Exhale. Slowly draw yourself through down to your mat. Take a little time here to relax, let go. We're going to transfer ourselves into our final Shavasana. If there's anything you're craving, I want you to take here with your body. If you want to come onto your back for your final resting pose, by all means, let's roll onto your back. If you want to stay on your belly right where you are, then by all means, stay on your belly wherever you are. I've got one little reading I want to say before I send us away today. So wherever you are, find your final resting spot. Take your time to relax and land in it. Maybe it's seated, maybe it's on your back. Wherever it is that you need to feel comfortable to relax. And I want you to be able to let go from your heart here, to let it just all roll off of your shoulders. Take a big inhale. Let's land in your final resting pose. Let your creativity blossom. For too long, you've held back. For too long, you have limited your natural creative learnings and talents. Maybe someone told you you couldn't create, or being creative wasn't worth it. Maybe you started telling yourself that you are creative. You have a creative self within you that wants to play, that wants to let loose, that wants to create. See the part and free yourself. Let yourself play with life, with work, with your projects at home, with baking. Try new things. When you find your connection to creativity, the entire universe will come alive for you. It will help you, guide you, inspire you. You will find yourself imagining something, then being led right down a path that will help you create it. When you don't know what to do next, listen to your heart and allow the universe to guide you. Creativity is the nature of the world, the universe. The universe creates, and the universe needs your help in creating. Creating brings yourself into harmony with yourself, the universe, and the rhythm of life. From the bottom of my heart, with all the love in the world, the inner light in me reaches out and touches the inner light in each and every one of you. Once again, my name is Sean. Om Shanti. Namaste. Thank you, everybody. I hope you enjoyed the yin tonight. Take your time, relax. Have a great evening, have a great sleep, and we'll see you soon. Bye.